Hi sir, now you have talked about aeration. So what is the, like, apart from aeration, what is happening or what is overall happening in a sewage treatment plant? Could you explain to us on that?
In sewage treatment, basically what is being tried to achieve is a set of reactions that will occur caused by a consortium of bacteria to break down the complex organic matter into simple organic matter, either in the absence of oxygen or in the presence of oxygen. Most of the times, sewage treatment plants are designed for treatment under aerated conditions. That means supply of oxygen for the reaction to take place in presence of microbial activity. Now, what happens in a sewage treatment is very interesting. It is basically the consortium of bacteria which is required to be maintained in the aeration tank, or what I call the reactor, for the given set of reactions to occur to decontaminate the water totally. One nice thing about sewage treatment, unlike the other industrial wastewaters, is the moment you have treated or decontaminated the wastewater, the end product is only two things: crystal clear water with a lot of biomass, which is digested, which can easily be separated from water to get absolutely sparkling clean water, which is fit for disposal. And when I say disposal, you can disinfect this clean water and dispose it safe into any place you desire. It regenerates the groundwater. If it is sent into a stream of water, it mixes, there is no problem, there are no health issues, and you are absolutely safe.
Yes sir, you talked about separation of the biomass. Are you suggesting that are we filtering it out, or it is by microbial activity?
The microbial activity occurs in the reaction tanks. Basically what happens is the bacteria grows into a phase where it can be easily settled, and this settling occurs very easily after prolonged hours of treatment. Normally all these organic reactions are very slow. They occur over a period of minimum 6 to 8 hours. In some cases it could take much more, depending on the degree of contamination of the water. So it is always preferable in sewage treatment to choose the type of treatment depending on the type of bacteria you're going to utilize for treating the wastewater. Now, typically what happens in any wastewater treatment is we always prefer to have biological treatment wherever organics, biodegradable organics, are present, since it's the cheapest mode of treatment as of today. Now, the difficulty in most of the biological treatment plants arise out of one issue: your ability to maintain the bacteria in the reaction tank for decontamination. That has been a challenge for most sanitary engineers. It's very simple. Everybody knows that if you have a system where you are able to maintain the microbial activity, the treatment is done. But the challenge is, how do you do it? So many processes have evolved, so many methods have been tried, but the difficulty occurs only in small and medium plants. Now, when we talk of a centralized plant for a large city where you have underground drainage systems, you will realize that it is much cheaper to have large systems where it will convey the entire city sewage into the network of pipes to bring it to a centralized plant and treat it. Because when these systems are large, you can afford to employ people who can run these plants and give you the desired effect or results of treatment. Now, the same thing when you decentralize, because you don't have the infrastructure or the network of pipes to convey the wastewater for treatment to some place, you don't have a choice. So you either have to restrict yourself to decentralize the operations of treatment, or most people in the cities or the towns would go for what they call the septic tank system. Now, septic tanks work well, no doubt, but at some point they have to be cleaned, they have to be treated further. The overflow from the septic tanks cannot be disposed of safely. It requires further treatment. The best way to treat wastewater, I think, is perhaps the aerobic system, where the water is fully decontaminated, there is no odor production, and the water is very safe and clean to use after treatment. Perhaps disinfection will be required depending on where you want to use the water. Otherwise, the water is pretty safe to be reused for any number of purposes. Now, let's go back to the treatment process when we are talking of the microbial activity. Interestingly, any biological treatment, what happens is, I was saying that you have to retain the microbial activity in the reactor to do the set of reactions to produce the clean water. The challenge for small and medium plants would be to have sufficient knowledge to ensure that the bacteria, the consortium of bacteria, is retained in the reaction tanks. It's not so easy as we talk about it, but a lot of methods have been devised, tried, and a lot more research work is still being carried out on how to retain the consortium of bacteria for the reactions in the aeration tank. Now, let me talk something about the microbial activity over here. There are two types of activity that can be looked at. One, what they call as the suspended growth, and the other activity is called the attached growth. Both produce the same desired effects. Ultimately, what is more important to us for attaining the best treatment is when you have the ability to maintain the cell count of the bacteria and the cell viability for you to treat the wastewater. Any technology that can ensure this, the consortium of bacteria being maintained, is perhaps the clear winner of treatment. You can definitely say that water can be treated without any ambiguity. So there are several challenges to this when it comes to downsizing plants to small and medium plants. When we talk of very large plants, technologies are available across the globe. Not much of a problem. Manpower is not a problem to run large plants, as capital and operational expenses are always taken care of by the institutions. So the governments fund it and you don't have a problem. But when you talk of small and medium, these are basically funded by private individuals or maybe the associations of buildings or societies. Now, what happens in these small plants is it becomes an expensive affair to have manpower, skilled manpower with knowledge of microbiology to run these plants because they are expensive. So there is a need to evolve systems where you can eliminate the need for personnel or skilled people to ensure treatment occurs. So devices are being tried out, and I'm sure there will be at some point anybody who comes out with systems which can run without skilled manpower is going to be very successful in introducing products to the market.